FLORA and GEMMA are both sewable microcontrollers made right here at the Adafruit factory. But if you're not sure which one is right for your project, this video is for you. GEMMA and FLORA are alike in many ways. They're both round with big sewable pads for connecting sensors and lots of neopixels with conductive thread. They're both 3-volt regulated devices with a handy JST connector for easily powering your project with a battery. If you're curious, we've got a video about those too. FLORA and GEMMA both have protection circuitry, so even if you make a mistake like plugging something in backwards, they're both hard to break. You can program both over USB with the special Adafruit version of the Arduino software, which you can download from the Getting Started guide for each FLORA and GEMMA. Besides being obviously smaller in diameter than FLORA, GEMMA's memory is also smaller. GEMMA's ATtiny85 chip has 5K of flash available for your program, compared to the Atmega32U4 chip on FLORA with 28K. So for big projects, FLORA is the way to go. You can see that FLORA has more pads around the outside. These are connected to the input-output pins on the chip. GEMMA has 3 I/O pins, and FLORA has 8. Some of these pins on FLORA are capable of easy connection to sophisticated sensors, like the FLORA GPS, color sensor, and motion sensor. GEMMA's more geared towards simple sensors, like pressure-sensitive velostat or this tilt ball switch. Since GEMMA doesn't have a serial port, it can't send data back to the computer over USB. I like to debug my code using a FLORA board so I can make sure all of the sensor values are in the range I'm looking for. Then comment out the serial commands and load the code onto GEMMA for embedding in my project. FLORA's got a few extra features, like an onboard on-off switch, a few more power and ground pads, and USB HID support, which means it can act like a keyboard or mouse. Many of our projects will work with a FLORA or GEMMA, like the sound-sensitive Amplitie, Firewalker sneakers, and Pac-Man suspenders. But if you're looking to make a sophisticated wearable electronics project like the GPS jacket, piano glove, or city bike helmet, FLORA is for you. GEMMA is perfect for lightweight and tiny projects like this bangle bracelet, galaxy makeup, and my birthday tiara. If you still have questions about which board to use for your wearables project, post them up in the comments, and I'll answer them on our weekly live show, Wearable Electronics with me, Becky Stern.